Welcome to the third lesson in the Google Tag Manager series. In this video, you'll learn how to test and preview the tags you've added to your GTM container. I will show you how to use Tag Assistant, and I'll also share a recommended workflow you can use when adding new tags to your website. Whenever you add tags, triggers, or variables to your container, it's always a good idea to test them to ensure they work as you expect and send the correct information to the platforms you're using. For example, if you've added a new GA4 event tag to your container, you should check that the tag is firing correctly before you publish it to your live website. Okay, let's head to Google Tag Manager. We can see that we have all of the tags we configured in the previous two lessons in our container. There is the Google Ads Conversion Linker tag and Remarketing tag. We have our Google tag, which is sending data to Google Analytics. Our LinkedIn Insight tag. And our Metapixel Base Code tag. Before we publish these tags to our live website, the next step is to preview and test our tags. So let's click Preview on the top right corner. A new tab opens for Tag Assistant. To use Tag Assistant, you will need to ensure that you've added the Google Tag Manager container code to all of the pages on your website. If you haven't added the container code to your website yet, then feel free to pause this video and watch the first lesson, where we cover how to install Google Tag Manager. Since I've already installed the container on my demo website, I'm going to enter the URL. I also recommend leaving Include Debug Signal enabled. This will let you preview events in Google Analytics using the debug view. Now let's click Connect. Another tab opens with the URL we entered. Our website loads. And we can see on the bottom right corner that we're connected to Tag Assistant. This means we can now browse our website and complete other actions to test our tags, triggers, and variables. Did you run into any problems connecting to your website? If Tag Assistant doesn't load, I recommend checking that pop-ups aren't being blocked in your browser. You can also try closing your website and refreshing the Tag Assistant tab. I also suggest using Chrome as your browser, and double-check that the correct container is installed on your website and that you're previewing the right container. Just make sure the container ID is the same in GTM as the one installed on your website. Okay, now let's navigate to another page. Again, we can see that we're still connected to Tag Assistant. Now let's open Tag Assistant. At the top of the window, you'll see your GTM container ID. And since we're using a Google tag to send data to Google Analytics, we can see the measurement ID for our Google Analytics property too. On the left-hand side, you'll see the pages that you've loaded using the preview mode. We can see both of the pages we viewed. We can also see the events that have been pushed to the data layer for each of the pages. These data layer events are what we use to trigger our tags. For example, if we select the initialization event, we can see the tags that are fired when each page is loaded. And if there are any tags that weren't fired for the data layer event, these will be listed at the bottom. We can select a tag to see more details. Let's select the Google tag that we're using for Google Analytics. We can see the details for the tag. For our Google tag, this shows us the measurement ID for our Google Analytics property. On the top right corner, you can also switch how variables are presented in Tag Assistant. We can see that values is currently selected. This means we're seeing the actual values that our tags are using. For example, instead of seeing the name of the variable, like GA4 measurement ID, we can see the actual ID. For my container, this is the ID starting with G-G75. Now let's change this to names. This shows us the names of the variables that have been used to populate each field in the tag configuration. So instead of seeing the actual measurement ID, we see the name of the variable. This can be useful when debugging your tags. For example, if a value looks incorrect or isn't showing up as expected, switching to names allows you to quickly identify which variable is responsible. You can then go back to your container to check and adjust the variable. Let's change this back to values so we can continue checking that the correct values are being passed to our tags. Below the tag's properties, we can see the trigger conditions that allow the tag to fire. And below this, we can see any exception triggers that might prevent the tag from firing. Let's close the tag. Apart from viewing the tags, we can also select the Variables tab to see the information that's available to use in Google Tag Manager. And the Data Layer tab lets you view the information in the data layer. Now let's select our Google Analytics measurement ID at the top. This lets us view all of the events that have been sent to our Google Analytics property. For example, we can select the first page we viewed. This lets us see the different parameters and values that were sent to our reports. Let's close this. And let's select our GTM container ID. Apart from the Google tag, we can also see the other tags that have fired. We can see the Google Ads conversion linker tag, the Google Ads remarketing tag, the LinkedIn insight tag, and the Metapixel base code tag for Facebook. All of these tags use the All Pages initialization trigger, which means they'll fire on every page of our website. All of these tags have fired, so we can see they're working correctly. In a future lesson, we will cover how to track a conversion action using GTM. This is where we will create a custom trigger that only fires on certain pages. When we create a custom trigger, it becomes even more important to preview and test your tags. Have you tested your tags in Google Tag Manager? Did you find any issues with your tags? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And here's my recommended workflow for Google Tag Manager. I recommend following these steps for any changes you want to make to your container, whether it's adding a new tag or even changing an existing tag. The first thing is to add or change the tags in the container. This might also include updating or adding triggers and variables. Then it's time to preview the tags, triggers, and variables you've added. Make sure you navigate to any relevant pages and perform any actions you're aiming to track on your website using the preview mode. As we've seen, this allows you to check exactly what happens. You can see the information that is going to be sent and check that everything is working as expected. If you encounter any issues, you can diagnose those issues while you're using the preview mode. You can also share the preview if needed. Next, you can check the draft version of your container to make sure that any changes applied in the draft are correct before publishing. You can also check the change history, in case anyone else might have been in Google Tag Manager since you started making these changes, to make sure that none of their changes are also going to be published when you publish. So that's how you can test and preview tags in Google Tag Manager. Have you previewed your tags using Tag Assistant? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And to learn more about Google Tag Manager, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. I will be releasing more tutorials for you. I'll cover how to track conversions using GTM, and I'll also be sharing my GTM checklist. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.